हरिहि ओम तत्सत्, हरिहि ओम तत्सत्, जय गुरु। आई वॉज स्पीकिंग ड्यूरिंग द पास्ट थ्री डेज इन द मॉर्निंग सेशन प्रभात रश्मि अबाउट ऑस्टेरिटी, द डिफरेंट लेवल्स, काइंड्स एंड क्वालिटीज ऑफ इट। एनी ऑस्टेरिटी टू बिगिन विथ will have to be based upon and related to the body and bodily limbs. Say regularly, we go and prostrate before either the idols and pictures of God or the knowers of truth, the Mahatmas, and even elderly people. Our prostration means not just folding the hands before them. It is bending our body, kneeling, making the forehead touch their feet, or even straight prostration, sashtanga pranama, before whomever we want to prostrate. Now this itself is an austerity. Going to the temple, doing pradakshina or circumambulation is also an austerity. Waiting there in front of the deity while arati is being performed, deepa aradhana, that is also one. Then chanting God's name as long as you are present inside the temple without indulging in any other secular talk, that is also an austerity. All these are physical. Then it moves to the oral level. Using the tongue we do austerity. What is that? Recitation of Vishnu Sahasranama or similar items, reciting Bhagavad Gita as we have here, then chanting various hymns and stotras addressed to various deities, all these also are austerities. Now with these two, physical, bodily, then oral, the visible part of the austerity is over, the gross nature, so to say. But the causal sphere in the human personality is inside the body. Every activity proceeds from the mind. It is initiated by the mind. The activity while it is on is subsisting upon the same mind. And as it concludes, it again comes back to the mind, gets terminated there, to remain as memory. Every day the event Prabhat Rashmi is conducted here. After some time we go away, dispersing from here. That event, there was a Prabhat Rashmi session, Pushpa Samarpanam session. I participated in it and I came away. Now this is in the form of an idea and a memory. So I would like you to clearly understand, though we have a body, the body itself is activated, implemented, employed by the mind. And the mind is not the body. Body is an aggregate of panchabhutas. The mind is besides the panchabhutas. All the panchabhutas are inert, whereas the mind is not so. It's an expression of consciousness. So the causal, as also the terminal level of all activities, is the mind. So we have to take the austerity to the mind level. What is that austerity? Employ the mind in an austere manner. You can think about it and have the type of austerity you want. Ultimately, it is a question of asking the mind to think. To think and express such emotions which are purifying, elevating, ennobling and fulfilling. The same mind produces a number of negative and adverse emotions. You have to get into the arena of the mind and eliminate all the negative emotions like undue love, undue hatred, undue fear, and their multiplications. At the same time, the mind should go on originating pure love, friendship, tolerance, kindness, consideration, sacrifice and all that. I always say love, sympathy and sacrifice are the three fundamental emotions or virtues of the mind. Get rid of the opposites and cultivate these. This is the real austerity. And so far as the intelligence is concerned, what is that? Employing the intelligence on either what is this wonderful God, the source of everything, the sustenance of everything, the dissolution of everything. What is that God or who is that God? This can be a thought. What is this world made up of? It has different substances with various properties, qualities and the like. And surrounding everything, all planets and heavenly bodies, we have the colorless, odorless, qualityless space. Obviously, all the planets and heavenly bodies have come from space. They dissolve into the space. Apparently, the space is nothing and nowhere. If the space is nothing and nowhere, from nothing and nowhere, can all things, a variety of things, ever be? Is it not a contradiction? Is it not a conflict? How do we explain it? How are we to understand it? This can be a thought. Another point of knowledge can be, who am I? What am I? Everything is mine, so I remains there. In sleep, we are unconscious of the world, the body, the mind, the intelligence and also the ego. Even then we sleep and get up to say, I slept. So in sleep everything goes into naught, nothing. And from nothing everything springs up when you wake up. So our wakefulness is really the creator of the world and our sleep is the dissolver. What is it in me which can wake up and create a world, infinite world? And what is that which is equally capable of dissolving and obliterating the whole world creation? So is not the I far superior to everything I know, I feel, I experience, I understand? What is that which understands understanding? What is that which makes the mind things? This is another knowledge. When the intelligence is applied to any one or more of these three, you will find that is austerity. Ultimately, it is knowledge austerity, jnana tapas. That is why Krishna says in the 12th chapter of Gita, mai eva mana adhatsva, mai buddhim niveshaya, nivasishyasi mai eva ata urdhvam na samsheha. Dear Arjuna, you only have to do a twin project. What is that? Fix your mind exclusively, unflinchingly on me, God, and fix equally your intelligence on me, God. Once these two fixations are over, then you will be living in God and your whole life will be godly, godliness and a continuous extension of it. Now, what do you think of this austerity? Ultimately, the austerity is such that you start understanding. The same mind produces a thinker. That thinker causes thinking. And thinking brings an outcome called thought. So how many are there? The pre-thinking substance, the thinker, the thinking and the thought. Four. Are there four? No. Only one. Then how does it produce the three? Find it out. It takes place nowhere else than within your body, in your own mind. And your mind is not accessible to anyone else. I would say even God does not access your mind. So get into your mind and understand what is the source of the whole thinking and emotional and ideational processes. ultimately you will find only one. The consciousness has the inscrutable power of bringing about anything, displaying anything, manifesting anything, and wrapping up all that. That is what it does when you wake up and when you sleep. Harihi Om Tatsa. Jai Guru.